Welcome again on the road here in San Jose. The TMC newsroom is alive and well with Anupam Sahai, president of eGestalt. So welcome, young man.
Thank you very much.
So I like Gestalt as a term because it means aha. So in terms of aha, we're talking about the identities and security and those kind of functionalities. So you've brought a security solution that's to the cloud now. Explain that. What are you guys doing?
Yeah, so we offer a cloud-based software as a service solution focused on small and medium businesses that are looking for a IT security monitoring and compliance management solution. So our vision is to bring security monitoring and compliance management to the masses, to the underserved, in fact, not even served SMBs. And there are about 3.x million enterprises today that are looking for a security solution. They're looking for a HIPAA high tech and a PCI solution, and they cannot afford the solutions that are out there. So our vision is to make technological and business innovations happen to provide a solution to that underserved space.
And in that space, there's always that craziness for SMBs where there are very small companies that can fly under the radar, and then as you start to grow, all of a sudden you find that you don't need IT staff, you need all these people
right.
That you didn't need before. So you guys are in effect easing the pain of growth for a lot of these companies.
Absolutely. So we work with channel partners who work with SMBs. So channel partners could be IT service providers, they could be security service providers, they could be compliance managers, security managers, whatever have you. So they're already working with the SMBs and they know them well. They understand their pain points, understand their price sensitivity. So we have created a channel partner program called Managed Compliance Providers Program, which helps these channel partners to be trained in security and compliance management. We have put together a whole set of technicals, marketing and sales collateral and packaging, which allows them to be successful. And then we've created a product that's channel ready, that's been priced to be exactly right for the SMB segment. Of course, nothing is exactly right. We always learn and fine-tune it. But the vision is to, the strategy is to go after the SMB segment through the channel partners by enabling them to be successful and creating a product that's priced correctly and designed for the channel.
And to that point, one of the things that you said, which I thought was important for those who are sitting there wondering about, you know, where the differentiation is, mm-hmm. is you in effect have created the best practice based on the service level of the company. So HIPAA is something that has requirements at various levels of employees and people that you're servicing. So you've in effect matched up the requirements to the marketplace you're servicing.
Absolutely. One of the key things that we bring to the table is what we call demystification of the security and compliance regulations. There's a lot of confusion out there with respect to, as a small business or as a medium business or as a large business, what does HIPAA high tech, for example, means for me? How do I go about implementing PCI? Or how do I go about doing security monitoring? So we've taken that confusion, as it were, in the marketplace, and we've created a product that has content that allows small businesses to do exactly what is required for them to be compliant or secure. The same set of methodologies may not be applicable for medium or large businesses. So we have segmented the market. We have created packages that focus on getting the small businesses, medium businesses, and large businesses ready. And the demystification of the security and regulation practices is a key value addition that not only allows end customers to understand what they need to do, but also allows our channel partners to get trained, become experts, and behave like experts when they go and talk to their partners. In fact, our partners tell us that it adds a lot of credibility and standing that they can talk about these regulations and security requirements in an intelligent manner, which otherwise they would not. They would have to go through gobs of,
right.
you know, regulations, which is legalese, essentially.
Well, often what I find is you have a discussion about HIPAA, and it never kind of breaks down where the piece parts go in terms of who has to do what. They
right.
just scare you with everything.
Exactly.
And you know, if I was somebody who was a small business, you know, a doctor's right. office, or, you know, my doctors actually work in a consortium of about 40, which is right at that perfect size for you.
Right.
So,
right.
So, you know, their requirements are somewhat less than the hospital, but you know, what it is, you know, they probably hired a lawyer who has
right.
given them everything, right?
And exactly.
That's not a good. So now talk to me about the price points for a moment. You're as a cloud service, you're not selling the boxes. So what's the price range difference?
Yeah, so we have, as I said, we have priced to be successful in the SMB segment. And as you know, SMBs are very price sensitive. So our entry level pricing for, let's say, a single doctor office starts at somewhere around $750 a year. It's a subscription model mm-hmm. per year, and it goes up all the way to, you know, 30K or 35K for a full-blown enterprise. And this is compared, you know, to the existing, you know, if you look at the solutions that are out there, they would cost you at the top end anywhere between $250,000 to $500,000 with professional services, everything included. So we're talking about 10x to 20x reduction in the entry-level pricing. A, to make it affordable for the SMBs, and because we don't have any proprietary hardware, any software requirements per se, we can deliver it and still be successful.
Now, are people looking to you to, can you be applied to a tablet or to a any kind of phone device? I mean, given you're in effect an SSL client or a TLS client,
right?
Coming to me, so in theory I could be anything, right?
Yeah, you could basically deploy the software any Windows operating system on the client side, on the CPE side.
Okay.
And we have auto detection software that allows you to figure out where the vulnerabilities could be in the network, and that is reported back to the cloud. Only the results of it. We don't go into specifics or don't move any customer specific data to the clouds because of obvious reasons, privacy
right.
reasons. But yeah, so we do the detection and we do the data gathering, and the results of the compliance gaps or security gaps are only uploaded for analysis by the customer. And every customer has a private instance on the cloud, total data partitioning, total security, excuse me, and complete disaster recovery of so
okay.
that there's no data loss happening at any point.
Okay, and last but not least, for the channel partners, a lot of these guys are selling boxes here. You're mm-hmm. kind of changing the model for them.
Right.
But do they get the benefit of recurring revenue as a result of re-upping
Absolutely.
Customers?
Absolutely. That's one of the key points of the MCP program, the Managed Compliance Provider program, is that we share the revenue with them because they are, you know, we are a 100% channel-focused company. We don't have a direct sales team that will compete with them. It's a 100% channel-focused company. We get a recurring revenue stream. We share it with them. Not only that, once a customer runs through the software, they find out the security and compliance gaps, they would in turn, that would in turn result in new products and services being upsold by the channel partner. So if, for example, somebody, you know, they do a security and compliance scan, and they figure out they need a firewall, they need an antivirus software or data protection, channel partners can come in and upsell and sell the services. Because security and compliance is a journey, it's a destination.
Right.
It's not a destination, it's an ongoing process. And channel partners become the allies to figure out what's missing and then taking them on a journey of making them secure and compliant. So
cool.
It's a managed security services and a compliance services operation.
Cool, and I can't wait to come take a look. I'm going to take a look at the
slide, the
screens, and I may have some friends for you.
Absolutely, would love to hear that.
Great, and thank you so much.
Thank you, Carl. Nice to see you.